ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ पूर्णमद पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ आप्यायन्तु मम अङ्गानि वा प्राणश्चक्षुश्रोत्रमः बलमिन्द्रियाणि च सर्वाणि सर्वं ब्रह्म उपनिषदं माहं ब्रह्म निराकुर्याम् माहं ब्रह्म निराकरोत् अनिराकरणमस्त्वनिराकरणं मे अस्तु तदात्मनि निरते योपनिषत्सु धर्मास्ते मयि सन्तु ते मयि सन्तु ॐ शान्ति श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ इत्येतदक्षरमुद्गीतमुपासित ॐमिति ह्युद्गायते तस्योपव्याख्यानम् बलं वा विज्ञानाद्भूयः अपि शतं विज्ञानवताम् एको बलवानापम्पयते सर्वदा बली भवति उत्थाता भवति उत्तिष्ठन् परिचरिता भवति परिचरन् उपसत्ता भवति उपसीदन् द्रष्टा भवति श्रोता भवति मन्ता भवति बोद्धा भवति कर्ता भवति विज्ञाता भवति बलेन वै पृथिवी तिष्ठति बलेनान्तरिक्षं बलेन द्योः बलेन पर्वताः बलेन देवमनुष्याः बलेन पशुवस्वयांसि च वनस्पतयः स्वापदानि आकीटपतङ्गपीलिकम् बलेन लोकस्तिष्ठते बलमुपास्वेति बलम वाव विज्ञान भूय है बलम द स्ट्रेंथ इज भूय है सुपीरियर टू विज्ञान सुपीरियर टू इवन नॉलेज वॉट इज बलम विज्ञान कारण मनोगतम सामर्थ्यम बलम इज बलम और द स्ट्रेंथ इज मनोगत सामर्थ्यम द स्ट्रेंथ विच इज इन द माइंड द मेंटल स्ट्रेंथ What is it? What mental strength? Vigne manasa vigne pratibhana samarthyam. Manasa pratibhana samarthyam. The capacity of the mind to comprehend. Vigne, the object that is to be known. The ability of the mind to comprehend what is to be known is called That manogara samarthyam. This is what is meant by balam. Not physical strength, but the mental strength. It is true that balam iti annopayoga janitam. That balam, the strength in the mind also ultimately comes from the food, as will be stated later. So how do you say that the mental strength comes from the food? Anashanat rugadini navaima pratibhanti bho iti shrehe. Shruti says, so Shvetaketu says, so anashanat when Shvetaketu fasted for 15 days and then when his father asked him to recite Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, etc. Rugali, Ninavayama, Pratibhati Goho. Oh, Venerable Sir, this Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, do not come to me. I do not remember them. This today. So the capacity to remember, recollect, all of that is due to the strength coming from the food. Sharirevi, Tadeva, Uthanadi, Samarthyam, Tatheva. Just as the samarthyam, the capacity of the mind is due to the food, so also the capacity in the body is also same due to same food, which makes the mind stronger, and the strong mind makes the body also stronger. So says बलस्य स्वरूप सत्ता मात्रम न उत्थानादि हेतु दैट देयर इज स्ट्रेंथ इन द बॉडी इज स्ट्रांग पावरफुल इज नॉट नेसेसरीली अ कॉज ऑफ दिस पर्सन डूइंग द वैरायटी ऑफ टास्क दैट इट डज किंतु अभिव्यक्तम कार्य सामर्थ्यम बलम तथा But the kind of strength that enables this person to perform variety of activities of sorts is that balam that is meant. Meaning that a person can be very strong, he can be lazy, he can be inadvertent, he can be depressed, he can be sad, in which case that merely physical strength does not come to help to accomplish various tasks in the life. So what enables a person to accomplish variety of things is the mental strength as manifested in physical activities. So these physical activities, the relevant physical activities, the appropriate physical activities, which are the means of successfully conducting yourself. That comes from the strength of the mind. No doubt, it is that in fact impels the body to do things. The mind impels the body to perform activities. But when can the mind impel the body? When mind itself has that strength. So ultimately, whatever we do, in terms of meaningful activity, which enables us to conduct ourselves in our day-to-day life meaningfully, and accomplish the variety of purposes in life, is really mental strength. Although outwardly, it manifests in terms of physical activities. So in that sense, sharirevi tadeva utthanani samarthyam. It is the mental strength alone which is samarthyam, capacity or capability, which makes the body stand up and do what is required, when and how it is required. The example is a bit funny, you know. Yasmar vijnanavata satam vikav prani balvan akampayate. Just as one creature who is very powerful, one human being is very strong also, makes 100 people stand up. 100 intelligent people can be made to tremble by one physically strong person. Yatha hasti mattah manushyanam satam samuditam api. Same way, just as, so what we find in an elephant, in rut, a mad elephant, how makes a gathering of 100 people also tremble. And so also a powerful person can make number of knowledgeable people tremble. So however that example means, you know, yasmat evam annadi upyoga nimittam balam. So just because the balam strength coming from the use of the food, meaning consumption, eating of the food, digestion of the food. Tasma saposho yada bali. So when this person possesses the right kind of bala, when he possesses the mental strength, which also requires a physical strength. So to perform variety of tasks, we require mental strength as well as physical strength. So balena tadvan bhavati. So balena iti karanathe tritiyaya ayamartha sputikritaha. That it is to the agency of the balam of the strength that a person so is called bali. So uttata, then he is able to stand up when the teacher comes. Uttanasya karta uttisthamsya gurunam acharyasya cha paricharita. Having stood up, gotten up, or having risen up, then paricharita, he served as the acharya or the teacher, guru. Paricharita paricharasya shushrushayaha karta bhavati. He serves the teacher or the acharya. Parichan upasatta. Then he comes close to them by serving them. Tesham samipagaha antarangaha priyo bhavati. Becomes one who is very close to the acharya. Becomes very dear to the acharya. Upasidanscha samipyavangachanna. So when this person attains that kind of samipya, a proximity to a teacher, inasmuch as a bond is developed between the teacher and the student. Ikagrataya acharyasya anyasya upadeshtu groho drishta bhavati. He gains the shraddha, bhakti, and the ikagrata, focus of the mind, single point of mind, meaning the ability to direct the mind to the required purpose. So drashta bhavati, he becomes the observer or seer. Tada taduktasya shrota bhavati, Let's say the drashta bhavati, he becomes a desirer of realizing the truth. So he attains what we call the desire, strong desire to know the truth. So because associated with acharya, then the resolve of knowing the truth becomes a mumukshu, becomes a jignyasu. Tada tadukta shrota bhavati. With that, then becomes a listener of whatever the teacher unfolds. Tataha manta bhavati. Really understands. So he, in his own mind, reflects upon what the teacher has taught and is able to logically fit everything together. Idam eva, idam evi uktam evam upapadyate. This is what the teacher said and this is what it means logically. So whatever he has heard or learned from the teacher, he is able to intellectually understand it with reasoning, to eliminate whatever doubts may arise in the mind. Manvanascha buddha bhavati. As a result of that reflection, he becomes a knower of what the teacher has said. Tata evam nischitya taduttathasya karta anusthata bhavati. Then whatever the teacher has taught has to be practiced in life. Suppose the teacher has taught some form of meditation, then karta bhavati. He performs that meditation, anusthanam. Vijnata bhavati anusthana phalasya anubhavita bhavati. So bodhna bhavati and vijnata bhavati, they literally mean the same thing. Bodhna bhavati becomes a knower. Vijnata bhavati also means becomes a knower. So then, what is the difference? So Bhashyakara said, anusthana phalasya anubhavita bhavati. Bodhna bhavati, he knows it intellectually. Vijnata bhavati, he realizes in his own experience. So all of these meaningful activities demonstrate the strength of the mind as manifest through the appropriate activities at the level of the body. Itascha balasya bhuyastam eshtavyam. So of course, to kari karana bhava is being said. Yasma devam balasya karanatvam. So balam is, and vijnanam comes again. So balam bhava vijnanat bhuya. What is vijnanam? Realization. Or seeing. So in this way, the Shruti has shown how the balam is ultimately the cause of vijnanam. When bali bhavate, then uttata bhavate, then paricharita bhavati, then upasatta bhavati, then shrota bhavati, manta bhavati, buddha bhavati, karta bhavati, vijnata bhavati. So vijnana is the last time. So yasma devam balasya karanatvam. All this vijnanam or the knowledge takes place only when the balam, the mental strength is there. Vijnanasya cha karyatvam. So balam is karanam, the cause. Vijnanam is karyam, the effect. Tasmat tataha tad bhuyastvam iti. So this is the Shruti, this is how explains the karya karana bhava between vijnanam and balam. Therefore, balam bhava vijnana bhuyah. Itascha balasya bhuyastvam eshtavyam. For this further reason also, that balam, the strength, is superior. So says, balena vai prithvi tishtate antariksham devbhu parvataha devanushya. All of these stand, meaning all of these are what they are because of balam. So earth, intermediate space, heavens, the mountains, and human beings, devatas, animals, birds, grass, trees, swapadani, ferocious animals, akita patanga pipilikam, and then all the way up to the worms, flies, and creatures, including ants. Balena lokas tishtati, that's how the whole universe stands because of balam, strength. Balam upasvati devahe narada, we meditate upon balam, the strength, because so great. So this can be said to be the stuti of balam. Earlier is the karya karana bhava, to establish how balam bhava vijnana, how balam is superior to or greater than vijnana. In this second part, can you say to be this stuti or extolling the balam? Because balami upasyam is to be meditated upon. So whenever you enjoin something, so may you do this, then you must always, in order to motivate that person, you always praise the reason why you should do that. Similarly, when the Shruti here enjoins balam upasva, may you meditate upon balam. Why? Because balam is so great. The whole universe stands because of balam. So that it is worth meditating upon. Now we read the second passage in page 314. Sayo balam brahmeti vaste. Yavat balasya gatam. Tatrasyatha kamacharo bhavati. Yo balam brahmeti vaste. Asti bhagavo balabhuya ite. Balabhava bhuyo stiti. Tanne bhagavan bravitvite. Sayo balam brahma iti upaste. One meditate upon balam as brahma, strength as brahma. Yav then, meditation means then identify, becomes balam, identifies with the strength. So, yav balasya gadam tatrasi atha kamacharo bhavati. It doesn't say that he attains lokas, endowed with balam, etc. Elsewhere it says, but here it says, what will be the range of balam or the strength. So, yatha kamacharo bhavati, he gets freedom of movement in the range where the balam of the strength extends. Yo balam brahma iti upaste, that's to the upasamara. One who meditates upon balam as brahma. Asti bhagavo bala bhuya iti. For venerable sir, is there something superior to balam or the strength? Bala bhava bhuya asti iti. Indeed, there is something superior to balam or strength. Tanme bhagavan bravitvedi. May the venerable sir please tell me about what is superior to the balam. Thus, at every step, the student is coming closer to the self. So there is a whole ladder here, beginning from the grossest, which is nama, culminating into bhuman, or the self. So this is the prakriya that is employed by this particular chapter. So the Tikakara said, at every step, upasya, the meditation can be done. So one is free to perform the meditation which is stated here. It does not mean that one performs all meditations. It is not even feasible that one can perform all his meditations. So yatha ruchi, one may meditate as one prefers. If the need be for antahkarana shuddhi and antahkarana naishalyam, for that will be purpose of meditation. Otherwise, it is merely realizing at every step how each following one is subtler and superior and closer to the self. So, proceeding to realize that. So now going to the next passage, says the Tika, bhuktasya annasya treda vidhiyamanasya yah anishtho rasah manasah upachayakarah manovayagatvena vartate sa balakanatvar baladapi antaranga bhuta ityah. So annamayani somya manah, it is said that the mind is made up of food. How? Bhuktasya annasya treda vidhiyamanasya. The food that we eat, which gets divided into three parts. Yah anishtho rasah, a gross part of the food which is rejected. The middle of the part of the food which gets transformed into flesh. And the subtle part of the food, anishtho rasah, manasa upachaya karah. That is what in fact nourishes the mind. That is responsible for the growth of the mind, nourishment of the mind, strength of the mind. Mano avayavatvena vartate. Therefore we can imagine that that subtle aspect of food remains in the mind as a part of the mind, nourishing the mind. So mano avayavatvena, that anishtha rasaha, the subtlest essence of food remains in the mind, nourishing the mind. So where the mind is, there food is. In what form? In the form of the subtlest essence of the food. So subtle, sukshma, not visible, but in that sense, it is there in the mind. Saha balakarantva, it is that essence, the subtlest essence of the food, which is the cause for the strength of the mind. Because the subtle essence of food nourishes the mind. And therefore, it is the food in that sense is superior to strength, balam. So, baladapi antaranga bhuta hityaha. So, it is said that the food is superior to the strength. Now, very strength, the mental strength. Then which food is superior to that strength? The subtlest essence of the food which goes to nourish the mind, sustain the mind, it is that essence which is superior to even the strength of the mind, because it is the cause of that balam or mental strength. So that is said in the next passage. Here we are told, annam vāva balādhūyaha tasmāt yadyavi dasharātrihi na asniyāt yadi uha jivet akhavā adrashtā ashrutā amantā abodhā akartā avijñātā bhavati yathā anyasya āyai drashtā bhavati shrutā bhavati mantā bhavati bodhā bhavati kartā. कर्ता भवति विज्ञाता भवति अन्नमुपास्वेति अन्नम वाव बला भूयः द फूड इज इंडीड सुपीरियर टू द स्ट्रेंथ तस्मात् यद्यपि दशरात्रि न अश्नीयात् therefore the person does not consume food observes fast for 10 days and 10 nights yadi uha jivet in all likelihood the person will die without the food in case he continues he survives then athwa adrashta then will be fine he is totally drained out even mentally adrashta ashrota amanta he cannot see he cannot hear he cannot diffract he cannot know he cannot perform upasana avijnata kar he cannot become vijnata or the knower so vijnan cannot be there if the balam is not there Balam cannot be there if annam is not there. So, karyakarana bhava. If annam is there, when a person consumes food, then the subtlest essence of the food strengthens the mind. When the mind is strong, then the activities of rising up, serving the teacher, all of this becomes possible. Otherwise, that is not possible. So again the karya karana bhava by vyatirika and anvaya. So first vyatirika, in absence of food, the balam is not there. So how do you say balam is not there? Because the manifestation of balam, which is in the form of the variety of activities, that is not there. If balam is there in the mind, then he will serve the teacher. He will have the desire to know, he will listen to the teacher, reflect upon it, see it, know it. But all of this is not possible in absence of the mental strength, which in turn is not possible because of the absence of food. So, vyatireka. Ata annasya ayai. So, when the food is received, अन्वय दृष्टा भवति श्रोता भवति मन्ता भवति बोधा भवति कर्ता भवति विज्ञाता भवति व्हेन द फूड कम्स ही रिगेन्स हिज मेंटल स्ट्रेंथ एंड देन ही सीज ही हियर्स ही रिफ्लेक्ट्स ही नोज ही मेडिटेट्स ही इंप्लीमेंट्स ही सीज और रियलाइजेस देयरफॉर अन्नम उपास्यते Annam is a food which is superior to the balam, mental strength also. Bhashyakara says, Annam vavalad bhuyah balahetutvat Annam vavalad bhuyah What is annam food? What is food? The subtlest essence of food, which strengthens the mind. That is food in that form. Food in the form of the subtlest essence is superior to the balam strength of the mind. See the Tika in the 935 Tasmaridi Ukta Shrotasya Hetoho Annasya Bhuyastve Sakshat Hetutva Anupatte So Tasmar, therefore इति उक्त श्रोतस्य हेतुः The Shruti tells you the Hetu. That when Annam is there, Anishtarasa is there, then mental strength is there, then activity is there. So Anvaya Vidreka is given by the Shruti. Therefore we say that the Annam is superior to Bala. There is no way for us to determine this. Meaning that we cannot really connect the two. That is the subtle essence of food, that is the cause for the mental strength. We know it from the Shruti. So, Shrutasya Hetoho Annasya Bhujasthe Sakshad Hetutva Anupatyehe. We cannot see from our own knowledge that Annam is the cause of the Balam. So, the reasoning is obtained from the Shruti Anvaya Vyatireka. Bhujasthe Hetoho Annasya Balakarnatve Hetutvam Darshayitum Aha. So, Bhujastva Hetau, that Annam is superior to Balam. Why? Balakarnat, because Annam is the Karanam, cause of the Balam. So, Hetutvam Darshayitum. So, what's a Hetu? That's what the Shruti shows. So, Bala Hetutvam, Bhashyakara says, Bala Hetutvat. Annam is the Hetu, the cause for Balam. The Bhashyakara continues, Katham Annasya Bala Hetutvam Iti Uchyate. So how do you say that the Annam is the cause for Balam or the strength? Uchyate, Shruti says that. Yasmat balakaranam annam tasmat yadyapi kaschida dasharatrihi na ashniyat saha annopayoga nimittasya balasya hanya niyate nichindriyate Yadi Uha Jive Dushyantehi Masampi Anashnantaha Jivantaha. Yasmat Balakaranam Annam, because food is a cause of Balam. Tasmat therefore. So that tasmat is because the Shruti says, you know. So, in Upta Shrautasya Hetoho Annasya Bhujasthe Sakshad Hetutva Anupatye. So, from the Shruti alone, we derive this relationship of cause and effect between Annam and Balam. Tasmat Yadyapi Kaschida. Somebody, even though somebody Dasharatrihi na ashniya does not eat for 10 nights, meaning for 10 days and nights. Saha annopi yoga, there is no extra akara there. So yoga, yoga nimittasya. So balasya hanya miyate. So if one does not eat food, then one does not get the balam, the strength that comes from the food. So if you eat the food, then you get the strength from the food. If one does not eat the food, let's say for 10 days, then there is a hani, there is then a loss of the strength coming from the food, because he is not eating for 10 days. Briyade, normally you would expect that the fellow would die. So why does Bhashyakara say, Yadi Uha Jive, in case the fellow is alive. Upanishad says, Yadi Uha Jive, in case the fellow remains alive. Meaning that normally you would expect him to go. So, Nachendriyate, meaning that in case he does not die. Yadi Uha means that in case he does not die. सीधी टीका जिसमान बल कायानंदम तस्मानेव बलस्य अन्वय व्यतिरेक युक्त यस्मात् बल कारण अन्नम बिकॉज द फूड इज द कॉज ऑफ बलम देयरफॉर तस्मादेव बलस्य अन्वय व्यतिरेक युक्त देन ओनली दी आवर दोषों से मदद नहीं कराना भाई पूछोगा तस्मादेव बलस्य अन्वय व्यतिरेक युक्त So because Anna is the cause of Balam, therefore Anna is Vitareka. If Anna is there, Balam is there. Anna is not there, Balam is not there. That Anna Vitareka would be appropriate only if Anna is the cause of Balam. So thus Anna Vitareka can establish the cause and effect relationship. Anyatha tau nasyata miti vishesha. Otherwise, Anvaya Vitareka would not be had Annam not been the cause of Balam. So that's why the Tikakara says that this we learn only from Shruti. We don't have independent way of establishing the cause and effect relationship between Annam and Balam. Tauyeva Anvaya Vitareka Darshayati. Those Anvaya Vitareka, Shruti Hastar shows Bhashyakara Hastar, Yadyapi Kasti Nityagana. Sri Jatika, Yadi Uha Jivayati, Yadi Shabda Suchitam, Jivanasya Durlabhattam Darshayati, in case the fellow survives. So Jivanasya Durlabhattam, It is very rare that a person survives in spite of not eating food for a number of days. That a person survives is something rare. And therefore, in case that fellow survives. So, Dasharatri, I don't know, for whatever reason, so 10 days, that's what Shruti thinks. That for an ordinary person, fasting for 10 days is enough for him to depart. In case he survives, it is something rare. So, saha anno payoga nimittasya balasya hanya meyate. Because of the loss of the strength that comes from the consumption of food, the fellow will die. Jivan ahave balasya ashanka eva nasti tyartha. When the fellow is not alive, there is no question of any strength in him anywhere. So, Vyatirika is very clear. If food is not there, this strength is not there. Nanu, anno payoga bhavai marna niyame na chendre devi katham jivana ashankayate. Anno payoga bhavai marna niyame. This is a rule that a person necessarily dies. In absence of consumption of food, if it's a rule, then why they say nachendriyate? In case he does not die, if there's a rule, then no eating, then no living. Then in case he does not die, why? Katham jivana ashanka? Then how do you have a doubt that the person may continue to live? So Vasakare, drushyantehi masamapi anashnanto jivantah. In Bhashyakara's time also, there must be Jain sadhus, you know, must be there. We find that people continue to live even after fasting for a month. So you cannot say that a person necessarily dies in absence of food. In general, a fellow would die, but not necessarily everybody. We do anandigiri athava yadi saha abhunjanapi kathanchi jive tada jivannapi sambandha athava yadi saha abhunjanapi same thing in case even without eating also kathanchi jive somehow he survives tada jivannapi then adrashta ashrota etc. That is So, when Shruti is adrashta bhavati, He does not see, meaning what? He is alive. So even after not consuming food for 10 days, it is possible that the person may be alive. But devoid of all the mental strength, therefore, incapable of performing those activities that are required for vijnanam. So vijnanam requires a number of steps. Beginning from respecting the teacher, serving the teacher, and seeking to know from the teacher, then listening to the teacher, then reflecting upon that, then understanding it, etc. Then only vijnanam comes. So all those steps would not be possible for a person who does not possess the mental vigor. The physical vigor also will not be there. He will lie down, you know, and so he can't do anything. So balasya ashanka eva nasti. Katham anasana, katham ashana shunyasya jivanam iti ashankya dushyante. Again, say, how is it possible that a person survives in spite of not eating? Because we do see that. So that is why there is no logic that we can apply here. There is no rule that we see that only people who eat food are necessarily mentally vigorous. That also we cannot see. Those who do not eat food also are not alive or not vigorous, also we cannot say. Therefore, that Anvaya Vidyayaka will accept only on the strength of the Shruti. That's all. Then continuing, Anno Upayoga Ahave Balahani Heti Vyatirekam Uktva. No, then that's later. Before that, says the Adhika, line 29, Nanu, that we already saw. So, Anna Bhave Kathanti Jivannapi Balarahita Evetiya. Anna Bhave Kathanti Jivannapi. So, this is what they say. That even if a person survives in absence of food, meaning not eating, fasting for a number of days in case the person survives, Balarahita Eva, he is devoid of all the bala, strength, physical and mental. Anyway, why do they say that? Because the Puranas describe all kinds of tapasya. For people remaining hungry for how long? Eating just this, what is this king in the Matsya avatar, that he was only drinking water, that's all. Some drink only leaves, eat only leaves and only breathe, that's all. Vayu bhakshanam. For how long? Huh? Dhruv for 6 months, oh, and Kanyakumara, Devi Parvati, Sati, and so many rishis. So, what Satyavrata, the king, was only living on water. When he had the darshan of Lord as Matsya, that we'll see. But, so 10 days is nothing really. These days, people go to all these naturopathic clinics and observe fast for several days. They survive only on lemon water and things like that for a number of days. Huh? Narendra Modi, yeah. 9 days. Only on warm water, that's all. So there are many. Jain sadhus, of course, are well known for their Jains. Why sadhus? Even grihasthas also, even Jain children. 12 years old, and they observe fast for 8 days. They celebrate. And so, in fact, the observation is that if you don't eat for a number of days, you become mentally more alert and agile. Then a time may come when you lose the strength. Yes, that is true. So, depends on a given body. They say that if you do not eat for 3 days, then your body starts eating from the reserved food in your own body, you know, fat, etc. It starts sustaining on that. So some people will sustain for a long time. But a time will come when they also consume all desire in their body. Then they will start becoming weaker and weaker and mentally also. It may be 10 days or 15 days or a month or whatever it is. But a time has to come when the body has consumed all the reserve energy. Then there is nothing even to strengthen the mind. Then physically also and mentally also the person will become weak. So even if it is 10 days or 15 days in case of Shvetaketu, 15 days. Shvetaketu survived for 15 days. And so, just Shruti herself has said that you can survive. Anyway, but as I said, there may not be a rule about 10 days or 15 days, but a general rule can be stated. It may vary with different people. But a time will come when all the reserves of the food is consumed. Then a person will lose the vitality physically and mentally also. So, anna bhave kathanti jivannapi badarahita hai. Ashuti says that in case a person survives in absence of food, then also he is devoid of all the strength. Athavachayati. So then Bhashya says, the sixth line, athava sah jivannapi adrashta bhavati guroho api ततः एव अश्रोता इत्यादि पूर्व विपरीतं सर्वं भवति. अथवा द टीका का अर्थ अथ च, सो द रीडिंग इज अथवा और अथ च, दैट्स व्हाट द लाइन 38 सेज. अथ च इति श्रोतो वा शब्द है और अथवा, सो श्रुति से अथवा श्रोतो वा शब्द च शब्द विश्व से अथ च एंड विश्व अंडरस्टैंड अथ च बिकॉज अथवा डजंट हैव मीनिंग और नो अथ च इन केस द फेलो सर्वाइव्स यू नो ततश्च अथ च इत्यस्य अपि च इत्यर्थं स्वीकृत्याह. So, tatascha then also, athacha iti asyari, cha iti artham svikrutya. Or athava iti asyari, cha iti artham svikrutya. So, va is equal to cha, svikrutya. Bhashyakara, the way he explains athava, he seems to imply athacha. So, sah jivannapi, that's what Vashyakara said, sah jivannapi. Athava means or, which doesn't fit here. Athacha in case, you know, so. Jivannapi adrashta bhavati, even if he is alive, he cannot see. Guru api, he cannot even see his teacher. Tatahiva ashrota, when you cannot see the teacher, then also you can say see the teacher. The seeing can also be interpreted as a mental seeing, you know. That he sees the teacher in the person, you can say. So, dashta bhavati, shrota bhavati. You become shrota, you listen to that person only when you look upon that person as the teacher. So, physically with eyes we see the person, but in the mental eye you see that person as a teacher, then only Shravanam becomes possible. So, I guess that also you can interpret that way, whatever, I don't know. But so, Dashtavati Guru Api, then he cannot even see the Guru. Therefore, Ashrota, when he cannot see, he cannot be Shrota, Manta, Drasht, Buddha, etc. He cannot be. Ityadi puru viparitam saram bhavati. In that sense, everything opposite of what was stated earlier will happen in this absence of the strength. Then says Annagari, Anna Upayoga Bhave, Balahani Hiti, Vyatirika Muktva, Tad Upayoge, Balam Bhavadidi, Anvayam Vyachaste. Anna Upayoga Bhave, Balahani. In absence of the consumption of food, there is the loss of strength. So no drashta, shrota, manta, that loss of strength. Vyatirika, this is Vyatirika. In absence of food, the absence of strength. So dupayoge, on the other hand, when the food is consumed, balam bhavate, then one gains the strength iti anvayam vyachaste atha iti. Same thing, another tika said, annam vyatirege balam vyatirektva tadanvaye tadanvayam aha atha yada iti. Okay. अथ यदा बहूनि अहानि अनशितः दर्शनादि क्रियासु असमर्थः सन् अन्नस्य आये. सो अथ अन्नस्य आये, द श्रुति सेज अथ अन्नस्य आये. अथ मीन्स व्हाट? यदा. When bahuni ahani anashitah, even when having remained hungry for a number of days, that means yada, when, so darshanadi kriyasu asamartasan, incapable of performing the acts of darshanam, shravanam, etc., yada annasya ayi bhavati, then when the food comes, he becomes the receiver of food. So Bhashyakara explains, Agamanam Ayah Annasya Praptihi Ityakah. So looks like Annasya Ayah, even though the printing is I, Bhashyakara says Agamanam Ayah. Alright. Well then, सायस्य विद्यते सह अन्नस्य आये. सो सिर्फ आये ही भाष्यकार सेज आई. सो आय है यस्य अस्ति इति आई. व्हाट इज आय है? आगमनम, द कमिंग. आय मीन्स कमिंग, अराइवल, अप्रोच मीन्स आय है. मीनिंग अन्नस्य प्राप्ति. Annasya aye means, so when food comes, when it becomes the receiver of food, sayasya vidyase saha annasya aye. So when for him the annasya aye, arrival of food happens, becomes the aye, means the receiver of food. So one for whom the food arrives, he becomes the receiver of food. So again, Nitika 31 line, Atha Yadda Iti Dakar Patha Spashta Atha Yadda. Now that is clear. Yatha Iti Thakar Patha Atha Yatha. Suppose that's the Patha. To Anashito Asamartha. Anashito means Asamartha. Yatha Bahuni Ahani Anashita Asamartha. तथा अन्नस्य आगमे समर्थ है इति व्यथायं कथा इति तथा शब्द अध्याहरण योज्यम. जस्ट एज वन बिकम्स इनकेपेबल इन एब्सेंस ऑफ कंस्यूमिंग फूड, सिमिलरली वन बिकम्स केपेबल व्हेन ही बिकम्स इन रिसीवर ऑफ फूड. इति अथा यथा इज देयर, देन तथा शब्द अध्याहरण योज्यम. Then you have to supply the word tatha and understand it this way. So Maharshi says, annasya praptihi ityarthaya. Annasya ayah, annasya praptihi, receiving of the food. So says Tatika, praptihi, upyoga paryanta. Not just receiving the food, but consuming the food and digesting the food. Not even only consuming, digesting the food is all understood. Anyatha prapti matrena bala anupatthe. Merely receiving food, so annavan annada bhavati. Not only you should become the possessor of food, annada, you should be also the consumer of food. When you consume the food, your good appetite. So consume the food and digest the food. So, sa yasya vidyate saha annasya ahi. Okay. So, one for whom ayah, the receiving the food has become, it is called annasya, receiver of the food. Then he, the Mahasakara says, next, Ayati etata varnavyatyena. So it's Ayati, I don't know what Ay means. It can be Ay, you know. It is so annasya Ay. The Sruti is annasya Ayai. Mahasakara says, Ay is taken as Ay. So either the Shruti says I bhavati or aye it either varna vyatyena, that E must be replaced by A and nasya aye. So what does it mean? So what was the second? Atha annasya aya ittavi paathe eva meva artha. So either it is annasya ayah or annasya aya. So same meaning is there. So varna vyatyena. So that I in the Shruti should be I. If it is ayah or it is aye or aya or aye because of sandhi. So ayah can be aye also. And ayah, ayah can be ayah or aye, either way. So look at Anandagiri. Atha annasya ayah ittavi paatha asti. In case there is a paatha, annasya ayah iti. Tatra annasya ayah iti etadeva padam anna prapti parataya vyakshayam. Annasya ayah, then ayah eva padam, that word itself should be explained as anna prapti parataya vyakhyam, means receiving the food, that's how ayah is to explain. Ekaram ekaratvena viparinamaya. So then he says ayah, I think that's what Anandagiri means, aye ityeva padam, anna prapta parataya vyakhyam, ikaram, ikaratvane, viparinamaya, varna vyatya, angikarat. Then ikara, aye is to inter, is turned to ikara, aye. So, aye must be interpreted as aye. In Shruti there is aye, read aye, but that they don't seem to read. If the paatha is I, that's what Bhashyakara seems to read, or aye, then aye should be understood as I and the receiver of food. Or, as the other tika says, athwa in the line 33, athwa आई इति यकार दकार स्थाने आई सुबी आदि वर्ण व्यत्ययन इट शुड बीन आदि बट इट सेज आई दैट आल्सो मे बी तदस्य अदनम आदह सस्य स्थिति आदि सो इट्स ऑफ रिसीवर ऑफ द फूड ईटर ऑफ फूड सो दिस टीकाकार सेड रिसीविंग फूड इज नॉट एनफ ईटिंग फूड सो इट मे बी आदह सो अदनम आदह आदह मीन्स ईटिंग सस्य अस्ति द वन ईट्स इज कॉल्ड आदि इति उपयोग साक्षात् प्रत्यय आदि इति दैट सीम्स टू बी द उपयोग आदि ऐकारांत पाठे भी वर्ण व्यत्यय आश्रयेण पूर्वोक्तार्थेव ग्राह्य इति आह सो इफ आय इज अ पार्ट इन द श्रुति देन आल्सो वर्ण व्यत्यय The I must be changed to he, e. Varna vityasana purokta. Same meaning has to be taken. That's all. Atha annasya. Nanu patadvayabhi katham annopayoga arthakataya vyakhyanam. Still, How do you interpret aya as the receiving of the food? Aya sandasya arthantarasya arisam. Aya word can also have different meanings. One of the meaning is income, you know. So aya kara vibhaga, income tax. Aya also can mean income. Profit, gain, etc. also are the meanings. So aya sandasya arthantarasya arisam bhavad. It asanka tatparadarsanadehe. श्रवणाथ तथा व्याख्यान सो तात्पर्य दर्शनादे श्रवणाथ सो द पर्पज इज बिकॉज यू फाइंड दर्शन एटसेट्रा टेक्स प्लेस व्हेन द फूड कम्स देयरफॉर दैट आई इज इंटरप्रेट रिसीविंग एंड नॉट एनी अदर मीनिंग दैट्स ऑल द व्याख्यान दृष्टा इत्यादि So Vashyakara says, Drashta ityadi karya shravana. So why do you interpret ayai or ayaha as receiving the food or as consuming food? Because Drashta ityadi karya. Because then Shruti says, Drashta bhavati, Shrota bhavati. Because the person sees, hears, reflects all of these activities which reflect the balam. They are seen, therefore, the cause of balam, anna must be there, therefore, ayay must be receiving of the food, annasya ayay. The annasya ayay, where is the question here? It is very clear, annasya ayay bhavati, receive of the food, anyway. Katham tad anna kaya mi rasankya, anu vedaniko darshayati. Just because it becomes drashta, how do you say it's because of food? So, Anvaya Vyatirika Vashyakara says, Drushyatehi Annopayoge Darshanadi Samarthyam Na Tadapraptav Atah Annopasvedi Even prapta, there is one extra a there, and the prapta, praptava, tad apraptavataha, that's actually, na tad apraptavataha, so, anna upasana, oh, that also is okay, or apraptau, ataha, anna upasana, so only when the food is consumed, then only there is capability of drishti, shruti, etc., and when it is not there, So since Shruti says Anvaya Vyatirika, therefore that balam is anna karyam is a result of annam or the food. So he says in darshanade tat kayatvam Anvaya Vyatirika abhyam darshayati same. How anna gives rise to all subsequent steps by Anvaya Vyatirika. उपास्ते विधिवाक्यम प्रतीकतः गृहीत्वा तत्फलं विवृणोति अन्न उपास्वेदे सो उपास्ति विधिवाक्यं प्रतीकतः गृहीत्वा तत्फलं विवृणोति I guess that's the second passage you have to say. And the Upanishad is all right, but where is Vidhivakyam Pratigraha Tat Phalam Vivanati? Where is Tat Phalam? Phalam is in the next passage. So this must be passage 1 and 2, that's what we should understand. No, that passage 2 is in the next page, anywhere. So, Anna Upasva, it's from the Shruti, it is taken by Bhashyakara, and the second passage, the result of the Upasana is stated. Okay, we'll continue tomorrow. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamana पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बालरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेदि मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमव्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः हरि ॐ श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः Hey.